about community. So how do we build great anchors in the community, one that unites as many folks as possible?
Great anchors in community. It's a very important to create. You know, there's a, I think this is an African proverb, it takes a village to raise a child. And we need more villages. I mean, we're living in a very individualistic society today. Like, I don't know how it is in Nigeria, but of course in Sweden, you know, people close the doors and everybody's in their homes. That's not the way that we used to do tarbiyah with children back in the days. That's not how we create ummah. I remember my father, his name is Hussein. My father, when I was a child, you know, I always asked my father, like, did you go to kindergarten when you were a child? How was it? Like, how was that, you know? And he said, you know, our kindergarten was the streets. We went out in the street and then we had Halima Khanum, and Halima Khanum was like a khala, like an aunt in the neighborhood who gave them yani proper tarbiyah, both with love and sometimes she was very strict. And all the cousins and friends were hanging out and all the parents and uncles and aunties were, you know, giving them tarbiyah. And that's exactly what we need. You know, it takes a village to raise a child. That's the anchor, the village, the ummah, the sohbah, to have that community. And we have lost that. I mean, I've just spoke with Brother Abdul Rashid from your excellent organization. Why do we even have nationality? Why do we have these borders? This is connected to decoloniality, by the way, because these national borders are just social constructions, honestly. It's not God-given. I mean, it's not God-given. As Muslims, we believe in Ummah, whether you live in Nigeria or in Pakistan or in South Africa or in Bosnia, we're one Ummah. And in order to anchor ourselves, we need to have that vision of Ummah. We need to have the vision of villages that take care of the family, that support each other. The second, and this is very important, of course, the primary anchor is to root yourself in the primary sources of Islam and to establish a fitri society, where you're allowed to live both in a horizontal level, which is the dunya, and always have your sight on akhirah, which is the verticality. So both, when I work as a counselor, I don't just work with my clients when it comes to their dunyawi well-being. I also think about their ukhrawi well-being, the akhirah, right? So I'm working on a horizontal level and on a vertical level, right? And this is also how we should anchor us. We need this type of perspectives being there, normative view in our cultures, in our countries, in our regions. And this is not the case today, due to secularization, which we have seen also in Muslim countries, due to the different ideologies that are not connected to our paradigm or that are not fitri. We see that people are going astray, subconscious and conscious. And you know, it's not easy. I'm not judging anybody. I'm first and foremost self-critical myself, because I have a lot of shortcomings, Allah knows, and I can go astray. But it's also to be aware, you know, like, how do we create a fitri society that we can anchor ourselves? You know, every time I go, for example, into Muslim countries, I always feel a peace in my soul when I hear the adhan. Here in Sweden, we don't hear the adhan. And that's just the basic thing of the psychology of being a minority. Even in Muslim countries, sometimes as a practicing Muslim, you're a minority because the norm is secularization or, you know, industrialization or, you know, rationalism or all these modern, you know, ideologies that has been normalized. Even our universities today, sister, even our universities today are divided into secular studies and religious studies.
Yeah.
They should be integrated. Historically, we didn't have secular studies or religious studies. Everything was religious. To study chemistry was to understand Allah. To study biology is to understand Allah's creation, right? So we need to go back to that fitri way of connection to Allah, and also in that finding peace, prosperity, also have adab al-ikhtilaf to respect each other's differences and have a good way of interacting with one another. And this is the anchor. And then you have the villages, and then you need to have all people as brothers and sisters towards each other, beyond just saying, you're my brother, I'm your sister, because that's something we always say. But how do you act as a brother and sister? Because your pain is my pain. Mm-hmm. Your prosperity is my prosperity. And then, inshallah, with that, we can grow. That's one of my thoughts in this, with regards to this question. Allahu Akbar.